10PD with the suspect down. The officers are in out to the hospital with PD.
That police call still sends chills down the spine. It was a year ago this week that Fort Myers police officer Adam Jobbers Miller was shot in the line of duty. He fought for his life for 7 days before succumbing to the gunshot wound to his head, delivered by his own gun after the shooter managed to get it away from him.
For the first time ever, you are going to hear from the man who trained Officer Jobbers Miller. He was working with Jobbers Miller the night he was shot. NBC2's Michael Raimondi is live tonight with his emotional story.
We're on Flint Street right now in Fort Myers, and behind us you'll see a white mailbox maybe just a couple hundred yards down the street, and that's where Officer Jobbers Miller was shot just a year ago. And a year later, we don't see any sign of a memorial out here or the struggle that started just across the street here at this Marathon gas station. But it's a different story 2 miles away at the Fort Myers Police Department headquarters.
Sergeant Dominic Zamet has been on the police force for 18 years. When you step into his office, you can see the passion he has for his job.
I'm a very sentimental person, so everything back here in my office has a sentimental value.
Next to the badges are pictures and a memorial for a Fort Myers police officer killed in the line of duty last summer. At the center of the wall are pictures of Officer Adam Jobbers Miller.
I always keep that up there, and I always wear one every single day on my arm, every day to represent him since he passed away. So these lights always remain lit for him every single day.
When Officer Jobbers Miller joined the force, Sergeant Zamet took him under his wing.
Adam and I were together for quite a long time.
For more than a month, the two were side by side as Jobbers Miller learned the ropes.
All the time. We're together all the time. Ultimately, I'm responsible for him, and so we together for a month and a half, and we got him out where he needed to be at the great officer that he was, and our relationship built from there.
After he completed his training, the two continued working together on the overnight Bravo shift.
I trained him and I was working with him that night, so this one along with the shift is a little bit more personal to us.
How often would you say you think about it?
Every day. There's not a day that doesn't go by that you don't get up and think about your fellow officers and make sure they get home safe at night.
PD with the suspect down.
A year ago this week, Officer Jobbers Miller was shot in the head on Flint Street just off MLK in Fort Myers. Sergeant Zamet drives through this area every day, saying he never stops unless he has to.
Very emotional when you drive by here, because you know you wish you could have been there for him. You could have done more. We never planned for this.
A couple hundred yards from this gas station is where police say Wisner Desmarais, a man with several arrests on his record, struggled with Jobbers Miller, somehow got a hold of the officer's gun and pulled the trigger.
When I saw the initial injury to Adam, I can't believe it. You know, I just can't believe it happened to Adam. It's hurtful coming back out here, you know, because I remember them putting him inside the patrol vehicle.
That is not the memory Sergeant Zamet thinks of when he is reminded of Jobbers Miller.
I think of Adam in a more positive light from training and from everyday contacts I have with him on the road and being in briefing. So I try not to think about any negative aspects.
He wants the community and his family to know the fallen officer will never be forgotten.
Each and every day, we are always remembering him. He's a very honorable young man and a hero in my eyes.
FMPD and Lee Health came together to honor Officer Jobbers Miller with a blood drive earlier this week, and Lee Health says that 327 people stepped up to donate blood during that 3-day donation. I'm live in Fort Myers, Michael Raimondi, NBC2.